This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Allied victory, collapse of Nazi Germany, fall of Japanese and Italian empires, creation of the United Nations, emergence of the United States and the Soviet Union as superpowers, beginning of the Cold War, more participants, Allies, Axis commanders and leaders, main Allied leaders Joseph Stalin, Franklin D. Roosevelt, Winston Churchill, Chiang Kai-shek, main Axis leaders Adolf Hitler, Hirohito, Benito Mussolini. Casualties and losses, military dead, over 16 million civilian dead, over 45 million total dead, over 61 million 1937-45. Further details, military dead, over 8 million civilian dead, over 4 million total dead, over 12 million 1937-45. Further details. VE campaigns of world. Southeast Asia, Southwest Pacific, Japan, Manchuria 1945, Mediterranean and Middle East, North Africa, Horn of Africa, Mediterranean Sea, Adriatic, Malta, Yugoslavia, Iraq, Syria, Lebanon, Iran, Italy, Dodecanese, Southern France. Other campaigns. Atlantic, Arctic, strategic bombing, America, French, West Africa, Madagascar, contemporaneous wars, Chinese Civil War, Soviet, Japanese border, French, Thai, Ili rebellion, World War II. Alphabetical indices, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. 0-9 navigation campaigns. Countries, equipment lists, outline, timeline, portal, category, bibliography, VE, World War. Including the Holocaust, in which approximately 11 million people were killed, and the strategic bombing of industrial and population centers, in which approximately 1 million were killed, and which included the atomic bombings of Hiroshima and Nagasaki, it resulted in an estimated 50 million to 85 million fatalities. These made World War forces into a war of attrition. In December 1941, Japan attacked the United States and European territories in the Pacific Ocean, and quickly conquered much of the Western Pacific. The Axis advance halted in 1942 when Japan lost the critical Battle of Midway, near Hawaii, and Germany was defeated in North Africa and then, decisively, at Stalingrad in the Soviet Union in 1943. With a series of German defeats on the Eastern Front, the Allied invasion of Sicily and the Allied invasion of Italy, which brought about Italian surrender, and Allied victories in the Pacific, the Axis lost the initiative and undertook strategic retreat on all fronts in 1944. The Western Allies invaded German-occupied France, while the Soviet Union regained all of its territorial losses and invaded Germany and its allies. During 1944 and 1945, the Japanese suffered major reverses in mainland Asia, in south-central China and Burma, while the Allies crippled the Japanese Navy and captured key Western Pacific islands. The war in Europe concluded with an invasion of Germany by the Western Allies and the Soviet Union, culminating in the capture of Berlin by Soviet and Polish troops and the subsequent German unconditional surrender on 8 May 1945, following the Potsdam Declaration by the Allies on 26 July 1945 and the refusal of Japan to surrender under its terms. The United States dropped atomic bombs on the Japanese cities of Hiroshima and Nagasaki on 6 August and 9 August respectively, with an invasion of the Japanese archipelago imminent, the possibility of additional atomic bombings, and the Soviet Union's declaration of war on Japan and invasion of Manchuria. Japan surrendered on 15 August 1945, thus ended the war in Asia, cementing the total victory of the Allies. World War 32, Spanish Civil War 1936-39-33, Japanese invasion of China 1937-34, Soviet-Japanese border conflicts 35, European occupations and agreements 4, course of the war 41, war breaks out in Europe 1939-40-42, Western Europe 1940-41-43, Mediterranean 1940-41-44, Axis attack on the USSR 1941-45, war breaks out in the Pacific 1941-46, Axis advance stalls 1942-43461, Pacific 1942-43462, Eastern Front 1942-43463, Western Europe, Atlantic 6 impact 61 casualties and war crimes 62 concentration camps, slave labor, and genocide 63 occupation 64 home fronts and production 65 advances in technology and warfare 7 see also 8 notes 9 citations 10 references 11 external links chronology see also, timeline of World War II The start of the war in Europe is generally held to be 1 September 1939, beginning with the German invasion of Poland, Britain and France declared war on Germany 2 days later. The dates for the beginning of war in the Pacific include the start of the Second Sino-Japanese War on 7 July 1937, or even the Japanese invasion of Manchuria on 19 September 1931. Others follow the British historian A. J. P. Taylor, who held that the Sino-Japanese War and war in Europe and its colonies occurred simultaneously and the two wars merged in 1941. This article uses the conventional dating other starting dates sometimes used for World War. Seizure of power in Russia, which eventually led to the founding of the Soviet Union. Meanwhile, the victorious allies of World War I, such as France, Belgium, Italy, Greece and Romania, gained territory, and new nation-states were created out of the collapse of Austria-Hungary and the Ottoman and Russian empires to prevent a future world war. The League of Nations was created during the 1919 Paris Peace Conference. The organization's primary goals were to prevent armed conflict through collective security, military and naval disarmament, and settling international disputes through peaceful negotiations and arbitration. The League of Nations Assembly, held in Geneva, Switzerland, 1930. Despite strong pacifist sentiment after World War I, its aftermath still caused irredentist and revanchist nationalism in several European states. These sentiments were especially marked in Germany because of the significant territorial, colonial, and financial losses incurred by the Treaty of Versailles. Under the treaty, Germany lost around 13% of its home territory and all of its overseas possessions, while German annexation of other states was prohibited, reparations were imposed, and limits were placed on the size and capability of the country's armed forces. The German Empire was dissolved in the German Revolution of 1918-1919, and a democratic government, later known as the Weimar Republic, was created. The interwar period saw strife between supporters of the new republic and hardline opponents on both the right and left. Italy, as an Entente ally, had made some post-war territorial gains. However, Italian nationalists were angered that the promises made by Britain and France to secure Italian entrance into the war were not fulfilled with the peace settlement from 1922 to 1925. The fascist movement led by Benito Mussolini seized power in Italy with a nationalist, totalitarian, and class collaborationist agenda that abolished representative democracy, repressed socialist, left-wing and liberal forces, and pursued an aggressive expansionist foreign policy aimed at making Italy a world power, promising the creation of a new Roman Empire. Adolf Hitler at a German National Socialist political rally in Weimar, October 1930. Adolf Hitler, after an unsuccessful attempt to overthrow the German government in 1923, eventually became the Chancellor of Germany in 1933. He abolished democracy, espousing a radical, racially motivated revision of the world order, and soon began a massive rearmament campaign. It was at this time that political scientists began to predict that a second great war might take place. Meanwhile, France, to secure its alliance, allowed Italy a free hand in Ethiopia, which Italy desired as a colonial possession. The situation was aggravated in early 1935 when the territory of the Saar Basin was legally reunited with Germany, and Hitler repudiated the Treaty of Versailles, accelerated his rearmament program, and introduced conscription. Hoping to contain Germany, the United Kingdom, France and Italy formed the Stresa Front. However, in June 1935, the United Kingdom made an independent naval agreement with Germany, easing prior restrictions. The Soviet Union, concerned by Germany's goals of capturing vast areas of Eastern Europe, drafted a treaty of mutual assistance with France before taking effect, though the Franco-Soviet pact was required to go through the bureaucracy of the League of Nations, which rendered it essentially toothless. The United States, concerned with events in Europe and Asia, passed the Neutrality Act in August of the same year. Hitler defied the Versailles and Locarno treaties by remilitarizing the Rhineland in March 1936. He encountered little opposition from other European powers in October 1936. Germany and Italy formed the Rome-Berlin Axis a month later. Germany and Japan signed the Anti-Comintern Pact, which Italy would join in the following year. Asia, the Kuomintang KMT Party in China launched a unification campaign against regional warlords and nominally unified China in the mid-1920s, but was soon embroiled in a civil war against its former Chinese communist allies in 1931, an increasingly militaristic Japanese empire, which had long sought influence in China as the first step of what its government saw as the country's right to rule Asia, used the Mukden incident as a pretext to launch an invasion of Manchuria and establish the puppet state of Manchukuo. Too weak to resist Japan, China appealed to the League of Nations for help. Japan withdrew from the League of Nations after being condemned for its incursion into Manchuria. The two nations then fought several battles, in Shanghai, Ri and Hebei, until the Tonggu Truce was signed in 1933. Thereafter, Chinese volunteer forces continued the resistance to Japanese aggression in Manchuria, and Shahar and Suiyuan after the 1936 Xi'an incident, the Kuomintang and communist forces agreed on a ceasefire to present a united front to oppose Japan. Pre-war events. Italian invasion of Ethiopia 1935. Main article, Second Italo-Abyssinian War. Italian soldiers recruited in 1935, on their way to fight the Second Italo-Abyssinian War. The Second Italo-Abyssinian War was a brief colonial war that began in October 1935 and ended in May 1936. The war began with the invasion of the Ethiopian Empire, also known as Abyssinia, by the armed forces of the Kingdom of Italy, Regno d'Italia, which was launched from Italian Somaliland and Eritrea. The war resulted in the military occupation of Ethiopia and its annexation into the newly created colony of Italian East Africa, Africa Orientale Italiana, or AOI. In addition, it exposed the weakness of the League of Nations as a force to preserve peace. Both Italy and Ethiopia were member nations, but the League did nothing when the former clearly violated the League's own Article 10. Germany was the only major European nation to support the invasion. Italy subsequently dropped its objections to Germany's goal of absorbing Austria. Spanish Civil War 1936-39. Main article, Spanish Civil War. The bombing of Guernica in 1937, sparked Europe-wide fears that the next war would be based on bombing of cities with very high civilian casualties. When civil war broke out in Spain, Hitler and Mussolini lent military support to the nationalist rebels. Led by General Francisco Franco, the Soviet Union supported the existing government, the Spanish Republic. Over 30,000 foreign volunteers, known as the International Brigades, also fought against the nationalists. Both Germany and the USSR used this proxy war as an opportunity to test in combat their most advanced weapons and tactics. The bombing of Guernica by the German Condor Legion in April 1937 heightened widespread concerns that the next major war would include extensive terror bombing attacks on civilians. The Nationalists won the civil war in April 1939. Franco, now dictator, bargained with both sides during the Second World War, but never concluded any major agreements. He did send volunteers to fight on the Eastern Front under German command, but Spain remained neutral and did not allow either side to use its territory. Japanese invasion of China 1937. Main article, Second Sino-Japanese War. Japanese Imperial Army soldiers during the Battle of Shanghai, 1937. In July 1937, Japan captured the former Chinese imperial capital of Beijing after instigating the Marco Polo Bridge incident, which culminated in the Japanese campaign to invade all of China. The Soviets quickly signed a non-aggression pact with China to lend materiel support, effectively ending China's prior cooperation with Germany. Generalissimo Chiang Kai-shek deployed his best army to defend Shanghai, but, after 3 months of fighting, Shanghai fell. The Japanese continued to push the Chinese forces back, capturing the capital Nanking in December 1937. After the fall of Nanking, tens of thousands if not hundreds of thousands of Chinese civilians and disarmed combatants were murdered by the Japanese in March 1938. Nationalist Chinese forces won their first major victory at Taizhuang, but then the city of Suzhou was taken by Japanese in May. In June 1938, Chinese forces stalled the Japanese advance by flooding the Yellow River. This maneuver bought time for the Chinese to prepare their defenses at Wuhan, but the city was taken by October. Japanese military victories did not bring about the collapse of Chinese resistance that Japan had hoped to achieve. Instead, the Chinese government relocated inland to Chongqing and continued the war. Soviet-Japanese border conflicts. Red Army Artillery Unit during the Battle of Lake Kasan, 1938. Main article, Soviet-Japanese border conflicts in the mid to late 1930s. Japanese forces in Manchukuo had sporadic border clashes with the Soviet Union and Mongolia. The Japanese doctrine of Hokushin Ran, which emphasized Japan's expansion northward, was favored by the Imperial Army during this time. With the devastating Japanese defeat at Khalkhin Gol in 1939 and Ally Nazi Germany Germany pursuing neutrality with the Soviets, this policy would prove difficult to maintain. Japan and the Soviet Union eventually signed a neutrality pact in April 1941, and Japan adopted the doctrine of Nanshinran, promoted by the Navy, which took its focus southward, eventually leading to its war with the United States and the Western Allies. European occupations and agreements. Further information, Anschluss, appeasement, Munich Agreement, German occupation of Czechoslovakia, and Molotov-Ribbentrop Pact. Chamberlain, Daladier, Hitler, Mussolini, and Ciano pictured just before signing the Munich Agreement. The 29th of September 1938 in Europe, Germany and Italy were becoming more aggressive. In March 1938, Germany annexed Austria, again provoking little response from other European powers. Encouraged, Hitler began pressing German claims on the Sudetenland, an area of Czechoslovakia with a predominantly ethnic German population, and soon Britain and France followed the counsel of British Prime Minister Neville Chamberlain and conceded this territory to Germany in the Munich Agreement, which was made against the wishes of the Czechoslovak government, in exchange for a promise of no further territorial demands. Soon afterwards, Germany and Italy forced Czechoslovakia to cede additional territory to Hungary, and Poland annexed Czechoslovakia's Zalesia region. Although all of Germany's stated demands had been satisfied by the agreement, privately Hitler was furious that British interference had prevented him from seizing all of Czechoslovakia in one operation. In subsequent speeches, Hitler attacked British and Jewish warmongers, and in January 1939 secretly ordered a major build-up of the German Navy to challenge British naval supremacy. In March 1939, Germany invaded the remainder of Czechoslovakia and subsequently split it into the German Protectorate of Bohemia and Moravia and a pro-German client state, the Slovak Republic. Hitler also delivered an ultimatum to Lithuania, forcing the concession of the Klaipeda region. German Foreign Minister Ribbentrop and the Soviet leader Joseph Stalin, after signing the Molotov-Ribbentrop Pact, the 23rd of August 1939, greatly alarmed, and with Hitler making further demands on the Free City of Danzig, Britain and France guaranteed their support for Polish independence. When Italy conquered Albania in April 1939, the same guarantee was extended to Romania and Greece shortly after the Franco-British pledge to Poland. Germany and Italy formalized their own alliance with the Pact of Steel. Hitler accused Britain and Poland of trying to encircle Germany and renounced the Anglo-German Naval Agreement and the German-Polish Non-Aggression Pact. In August 1939, Germany and the Soviet Union signed the Molotov-Ribbentrop Pact, a non-aggression treaty with a secret protocol. The parties gave each other rights to spheres of influence: Western Poland and Lithuania for Germany, Eastern Poland, Finland, Estonia, Latvia and Bessarabia for the USSR. It also raised the question of continuing Polish independence. The agreement was crucial to Hitler because it assured that Germany would not have to face the prospect of a two-front war, as it had in World War I. After it defeated Poland, the situation reached a general crisis in late August as German troops continued to mobilize against the Polish border. In a private meeting with the Italian foreign minister, Count Ciano, Hitler asserted that Poland was a doubtful neutral that needed to either yield to his demands or be liquidated to prevent it from drawing off German troops in the future unavoidable war with the Western democracies. He did not believe Britain or France would intervene in the conflict. On the 23rd of August, Hitler ordered the attack to proceed on the 26th of August, but upon hearing that Britain had concluded a formal mutual assistance pact with Poland and that Italy would maintain neutrality, he decided to delay it in response to British requests for direct negotiations to avoid war. Germany made demands on Poland, which only served as a pretext to worsen relations. On the 29th of August, Hitler demanded that a Polish plenipotentiary immediately travel to Berlin to negotiate the handover of Danzig, and to allow a plebiscite in the Polish corridor in which the German minority would vote on secession. The Poles refused to comply with the German demands, and on the night of 30-31 August, in a violent meeting with the British ambassador Neville Henderson, Ribbentrop declared that Germany considered its claims rejected. Course of the war. Further information, diplomatic history of World War II. War breaks out in Europe 1939-40. Main articles, invasion of Poland, occupation of Poland 1939-45, Nazi crimes against the Polish nation, Soviet invasion of Poland, and Soviet repressions of Polish citizens 1939-46. Soldiers of the German Wehrmacht tearing down the border crossing between Poland and the Free City of Danzig, 1 September 1939. On 1 September 1939, Germany invaded Poland under the false pretext that the Poles had carried out a series of sabotage operations against German targets near the border. 2 days later, on 3 September, after a British ultimatum to Germany to cease military operations was ignored, Britain and France, followed by the fully independent dominions of the British Commonwealth, Australia 3 September, Canada 10 September, New Zealand 3 September, and South Africa 6 September, declared war on Germany. However, initially the alliance provided limited direct military support to Poland, consisting of a cautious, half-hearted French probe into the Saarland. The Western Allies also began a naval blockade of Germany, which aimed to damage the country's economy and war effort. Germany responded by ordering U-boat warfare against Allied merchant and warships, which was to later escalate into the Battle of the Atlantic. German tanks near the city of Bydgoszcz, during the invasion of Poland, September 1939. On 17 September 1939, after signing a ceasefire with Japan, the Soviets invaded Poland from the east. The Polish army was defeated and Warsaw surrendered to the Germans on 27 September, with final pockets of resistance surrendering on 6 October. Poland's territory was divided between Germany and the Soviet Union, with Lithuania and Slovakia also receiving small shares after the defeat of Poland's armed forces. The Polish resistance established an underground state and a partisan home army. About 100,000 Polish military personnel were evacuated to Romania and the Baltic countries. Many of these soldiers later fought against the Germans in other theaters of the war. Poland's Enigma codebreakers were also evacuated to France. On 6 October, Hitler made a public peace overture to Britain and France, but said that the future of Poland was to be determined exclusively by Germany, and the Soviet Union Chamberlain rejected this on 12 October, saying, "Past experience has shown that no reliance can be placed upon the promises of the present German government." After this rejection, Hitler ordered an immediate offensive against France, but bad weather forced repeated postponements until the spring of 1940. German and Soviet army officers pictured shaking hands after Nazi Germany and Soviet Union annexed new territories in Eastern Europe. 1939, after signing the German-Soviet Treaty of Friendship, Cooperation and Demarcation, the Soviet Union forced the Baltic countries, Estonia, Latvia and Lithuania, to allow it to station Soviet troops in their countries under pacts of mutual assistance. Finland rejected territorial demands, prompting a Soviet invasion in November 1939. The resulting Winter War ended in March 1940 with Finnish concessions. Britain and France, treating the Soviet attack on Finland as tantamount to its entering the war on the side of the Germans, responded to the Soviet invasion by supporting the USSR's expulsion from the League of Nations in June 1940. The Soviet Union forcibly annexed Estonia, Latvia and Lithuania, and the disputed Romanian regions of Bessarabia, northern Bukovina and Herzegovina. Meanwhile, Nazi-Soviet political rapprochement and economic cooperation gradually stalled, and both states began preparations for war. Western Europe 1940-41 map of the French Maginot Line. In April 1940, Germany invaded Denmark and Norway to protect shipments of iron ore from Sweden, which the Allies were attempting to cut off by unilaterally mining neutral Norwegian waters. Denmark capitulated after a few hours, and despite Allied support, during which the important harbour of Narvik temporarily was recaptured from the Germans, Norway was conquered within 2 months. British discontent over the Norwegian campaign led to the replacement of the British Prime Minister, Neville Chamberlain, with Winston Churchill. On 10 May 1940, Germany launched an offensive against France and, adhering to the Manstein Plan, also attacked the neutral nations of Belgium, the Netherlands, and Luxembourg. On 10 May 1940, that same day, British forces landed in Iceland and the Faroes to preempt a possible German invasion of the islands. The U.S., in close cooperation with the Danish envoy to Washington, D.C., agreed to protect Greenland, laying the political framework for the formal establishment of bases. In April 1941, the Netherlands and Belgium were overrun using blitzkrieg tactics in a few days and weeks, respectively. The French fortified Maginot Line and the main body of the Allied forces which had moved into Belgium were circumvented by a flanking movement through the thickly wooded Ardennes region, mistakenly perceived by Allied planners as an impenetrable natural barrier against armoured vehicles. As a result, the bulk of the Allied armies found themselves trapped in an encirclement and were beaten. The majority were taken prisoner, whilst over 300,000, mostly British and French, were evacuated from the continent at Dunkirk by early June. Although abandoning almost all of their equipment on 10 June, Italy invaded France, declaring war on both France and the United Kingdom. Paris fell to the Germans on the 14th 19th of June, and 8 days later France signed an armistice with Germany and was soon divided into German and Italian occupation zones, and an unoccupied rump state under the Vichy regime, which, though officially neutral, was generally aligned with Germany. France kept its fleet, but the British feared the Germans would seize it, so on 3 July, the British attacked it view of London after the German Blitz. The 29th of December 1940, the Battle of Britain began in early July with Luftwaffe attacks on shipping and harbours on the 19th of July. Hitler again publicly offered to end the war, saying he had no desire to destroy the British Empire. The United Kingdom rejected this ultimatum. The main German air superiority campaign started in August but failed to defeat RAF Fighter Command, and a proposed invasion was postponed indefinitely. On 17 September, the German strategic bombing offensive intensified as night attacks on London and other cities in the Blitz, but largely failed to disrupt the British war effort. German Luftwaffe, Heinkel He 111 bombers during the Battle of Britain using newly captured French ports. The German Navy enjoyed success against an overextended Royal Navy, using U-boats against British shipping in the Atlantic. The British scored a significant victory on 27 May 1941 by sinking the German battleship Bismarck. Perhaps most importantly, during the Battle of Britain the Royal Air Force had successfully resisted the Luftwaffe's assault, and the German bombing campaign largely ended in May 1941. Throughout this period, the neutral United States took measures to assist China and the Western Allies. In November 1939, the American Neutrality Act was amended to allow cash and carry purchases by the Allies. In 1940, following the German capture of Paris, the size of the United States Navy was significantly increased. In September, the United States further agreed to a trade of American destroyers for British bases. Still, a large majority of the American public continued to oppose any direct military intervention into the conflict well into 1941. Although Roosevelt had promised to keep the United States out of the war, he nevertheless took concrete steps to prepare for war. In December 1940, he accused Hitler of planning world conquest and ruled out negotiations as useless, calling for the U.S. to become an arsenal for democracy, and promoted the passage of lend-lease aid to support the British war effort in January 1941. Secret high-level staff talks with the British began for the purposes of determining how to defeat Germany should the U.S. enter the war. They decided on a number of offensive policies, including an air offensive, the early elimination of Italy, raids, support of resistance groups, and the capture of positions to launch an offensive against Germany at the end of September 1940. The Tripartite Pact united Japan, Italy, and Germany to formalize the Axis powers. The Tripartite Pact stipulated that any country, with the exception of the Soviet Union, not in the war which attacked any Axis power, would be forced to go to war against all three. The Axis expanded in November 1940 when Hungary, Slovakia and Romania joined the Tripartite Pact. Romania would make a major contribution, as did Hungary, to the Axis war against the USSR, partially to recapture territory ceded to the USSR, partially to pursue its leader Ion Antonescu's desire to combat communism. Mediterranean 1940-41 Australian troops of the British Commonwealth Forces manned a frontline trench during the Siege of Tobruk. North African Campaign, August 1941 Italy began operations in the Mediterranean, initiating a siege of Malta in June, conquering British Somaliland in August, and making an incursion into British-held Egypt in September 1940. In October 1940, Italy started the Greco-Italian War because of Mussolini's jealousy of Hitler's success, but within days was repulsed and pushed back into Albania, where a stalemate soon occurred. The United Kingdom responded to Greek requests for assistance by sending troops to Crete and providing air support to Greece. Hitler decided that when the weather improved he would take action against Greece to assist the Italians and prevent the British from gaining a foothold in the Balkans, to strike against the British naval dominance of the Mediterranean, and to secure his hold on Romanian oil. In December 1940, British Commonwealth forces began counter-offensives against Italian forces in Egypt and Italian East Africa. The offensive in North Africa was highly successful, and by early February 1941 Italy had lost control of eastern Libya and large numbers of Italian troops had been taken prisoner. The Italian Navy also suffered significant defeats, with the Royal Navy putting three Italian battleships out of commission by a carrier attack at Taranto, and neutralizing several more warships at the Battle of Cape Matapan. Captured German Africa Corps soldiers. December 1941 1941 the Germans soon intervened to assist Italy. Hitler sent German forces to Libya in February, and by the end of March they had launched an offensive which drove back the Commonwealth forces which had been weakened to support Greece in under a month. Commonwealth forces were pushed back into Egypt with the exception of the besieged port of Tobruk. The Commonwealth attempted to dislodge Axis forces in May and again in June, but failed on both occasions. By late March 1941, following Bulgaria's signing of the Tripartite Pact, the Germans were in position to intervene in Greece. Plans were changed, however, because of developments in neighboring Yugoslavia. The Yugoslav government had signed the Tripartite Pact on 25 March, only to be overthrown 2 days later by a British-encouraged coup. Hitler viewed the new regime as hostile and immediately decided to eliminate it on 6 April. Germany simultaneously invaded both Yugoslavia and Greece, making rapid progress and forcing both nations to surrender within the month. The British were driven from the Balkans after Germany conquered the Greek island of Crete by the end of May. Although the Axis victory was swift, bitter partisan warfare subsequently broke out against the Axis occupation of Yugoslavia, which continued until the end of the war. The Allies did have some successes during this time in the Middle East. Commonwealth forces first quashed an uprising in Iraq which had been supported by German aircraft from bases within Vichy-controlled Syria, then, with the assistance of the Free French, invaded Syria and Lebanon to prevent further such occurrences. Axis attack on the USSR 1941. Further information, Operation Barbarossa, Einsatzgruppen, World War II casualties of the Soviet Union, and Nazi crimes against Soviet POWs. European Theater of World War II animation map, 1939-1945, red, Western Allies and Soviet Union after 1941, green, Soviet Union before 1941, blue, Axis powers with the situation in Europe and Asia relatively stable. Germany, Japan, and the Soviet Union made preparations with the Soviets wary of mounting tensions with Germany and the Japanese planning to take advantage of the European war by seizing resource-rich European possessions in Southeast Asia. The two powers signed the Soviet-Japanese Neutrality Pact in April 1941. By contrast, the Germans were steadily making preparations for an attack on the Soviet Union, massing forces on the Soviet border. Hitler believed that Britain's refusal to end the war was based on the hope that the United States and the Soviet Union would enter the war against Germany sooner or later. He therefore decided to try to strengthen Germany's relations with the Soviets, or failing that, to attack and eliminate them as a factor. In November 1940, negotiations took place to determine if the Soviet Union would join the Tripartite Pact. The Soviets showed some interest, but asked for concessions from Finland, Bulgaria, Turkey, and Japan that Germany considered unacceptable. On 18 December 1940, Hitler issued the directive to prepare for an invasion of the Soviet Union on 22 June 1941. Germany, supported by Italy and Romania, invaded the Soviet Union in Operation Barbarossa, with Germany accusing the Soviets of plotting against them. They were joined shortly by Finland and Hungary. The primary targets of this surprise offensive were the Baltic region, Moscow and Ukraine, with the ultimate goal of ending the 1941 campaign near the Arkhangelsk-Astrakhan line. From the Caspian to the White Seas, Hitler's objectives were to eliminate the Soviet Union as a military power, exterminate communism, generate Lebensraum, living space, by dispossessing the native population and guarantee access to the strategic resources needed to defeat Germany's remaining rivals. Although the Red Army was preparing for strategic counter-offensives before the war, Barbarossa forced the Soviet Supreme Command to adopt a strategic defense during the summer. The Axis made significant gains into Soviet territory, inflicting immense losses in both personnel and materiel by the middle of August. However, the German Army High Command decided to suspend the offensive of a considerably depleted Army Group Center, and to divert the 2nd Panzer Group to reinforce troops advancing towards central Ukraine and Leningrad. The Kiev offensive was overwhelmingly successful, resulting in encirclement and elimination of 4 Soviet armies, and made further advance into Crimea and industrially developed eastern Ukraine. The First Battle of Kharkiv. Possible Soviet civilians in Leningrad leaving destroyed houses, after a German bombardment of the city. Battle of Leningrad, 10 December 1942. The diversion of 3/4 of the Axis troops and the majority of their air forces from France and the Central Mediterranean to the Eastern Front prompted Britain to reconsider its grand strategy in July. The UK and the Soviet Union formed a military alliance against Germany. The British and Soviets invaded Iran to secure the Persian Corridor and Iran's oil fields in August. The United Kingdom and the United States jointly issued the Atlantic Charter by October. Axis operational objectives in Ukraine and the Baltic region were achieved, with only the sieges of Leningrad and Sevastopol, continuing a major offensive against Moscow, was renewed. After 2 months of fierce battles in increasingly harsh weather, the German army almost reached the outer suburbs of Moscow, where the exhausted troops were forced to suspend their offensive. Large territorial gains were made by Axis forces, but their campaign had failed to achieve its main objectives. Two key cities remained in Soviet hands, the Soviet capability to resist was not broken, and the Soviet Union retained a considerable part of its military potential. The blitzkrieg phase of the war in Europe had ended by early December. Freshly mobilized reserves allowed the Soviets to achieve numerical parity with Axis troops. This, as well as intelligence data which established that a minimal number of Soviet troops in the east would be sufficient to deter any attack by the Japanese Kwantung Army, allowed the Soviets to begin a massive counter-offensive that started on 5 December all along the front and pushed German troops 100-250 km 62-155. Repulsed during Battle of Shanghai in September, Japan attempted to take the city of Changsha again and clashed with Chinese nationalist forces Mitsubishi A6M2-0 fighters on the Imperial Japanese Navy aircraft carrier Shokaku. Just before the attack on Pearl Harbor, German successes in Europe encouraged Japan to increase pressure on European governments in Southeast Asia. The Dutch government agreed to provide Japan some oil supplies from the Dutch East Indies, but negotiations for additional access to their resources ended in failure in June 1941. In July 1941, Japan sent troops to southern Indochina, thus threatening British and Dutch possessions in the Far East. The United States, United Kingdom, and other Western governments reacted to this move with a freeze on Japanese assets and a total oil embargo. Since early 1941, the United States and Japan had been engaged in negotiations in an attempt to improve their strained relations and end the war in China. During these negotiations, Japan advanced a number of proposals which were dismissed by the Americans as inadequate. At the same time, the U.S., Britain, and the Netherlands engaged in secret discussions for the joint defense of their territories. In the event of a Japanese attack against any of them, Roosevelt reinforced the Philippines, an American protectorate scheduled for independence in 1946, and warned Japan that the U.S. would react to Japanese attacks against any neighboring countries. USS war to prevent American intervention while securing the perimeter. It was further planned to neutralize the United States Pacific Fleet and the American military presence in the Philippines from the outset on 7 December 1941, 8 December in Asian time zones. Japan attacked British and American holdings with near simultaneous offensives against Southeast Asia and the Central Pacific. These included an attack on the American fleet at Pearl Harbor, the Philippines, landings in Thailand and Malaya, and the Battle of Hong Kong. These attacks led the United States, Britain, China, Australia, and several other states to formally declare war on Japan, whereas the Soviet Union, being heavily involved in large-scale hostilities with European Axis countries, maintained its neutrality agreement with Japan. Germany, followed by the other Axis states, declared war on the United States in solidarity with Japan, citing as justification the American attacks on German war vessels that had been ordered by Roosevelt. Axis advance stalls 1942-43. Seated at the Casablanca Conference, U.S. President Franklin D. Roosevelt and British PM Winston Churchill, January 1943. In January 1942, the Allied Big Four, the United States, Britain, the Soviet Union and China, and 22 smaller or exiled governments, issued the Declaration by United Nations, thereby affirming the Atlantic Charter, and agreeing to not to sign a separate peace with the Axis powers. During 1942, Allied officials debated on the appropriate grand strategy to pursue. All agreed that defeating Germany was the primary objective. The Americans favored a straightforward, large-scale attack on Germany through France. The Soviets were also demanding a second front. The British, on the other hand, argued that military operations should target peripheral areas to wear out German strength, lead to increasing demoralization, and bolster resistance forces. Germany itself would be subject to a heavy bombing campaign, and offensive against Germany would then be launched primarily by Allied armor without using large-scale armies. Eventually, the British persuaded the Americans that a landing in France was infeasible in 1942 and they should instead focus on driving the Axis out of North Africa. At the Casablanca Conference in early 1943, the Allies reiterated the statements issued in the 1942 Declaration by the United Nations, and demanded the unconditional surrender of their enemies. The British and Americans agreed to continue to press the initiative in the Mediterranean by invading Sicily to fully secure the Mediterranean supply routes, although the British argued for further operations in the Balkans to bring Turkey into the war. In May 1943, the Americans extracted a British commitment to limit Allied operations in the Mediterranean to an invasion of the Italian mainland and to invade France in 1944 Pacific 1942-43. Map of Japanese military advances. Until mid-1942, by the end of April 1942, Japan and its ally Thailand had almost fully conquered Burma, Malaya, the Dutch East Indies, Singapore, and Rabaul, inflicting severe losses on Allied troops and taking a large number of prisoners despite stubborn resistance by Filipino and U.S. forces. The Philippine Commonwealth was eventually captured in May 1942, forcing its government into exile on 16 April. In Burma, 7,000 British soldiers were encircled by the Japanese 33rd Division during the Battle of Yenangueang and rescued by the Chinese 38th Division. Japanese forces also achieved naval victories in the South China Sea, Java Sea and Indian Ocean, and bombed the Allied naval base at Darwin, Australia in January 1942. The only Allied success against Japan was a Chinese victory at Changsha. These easy victories over unprepared U.S. and European opponents left Japan overconfident, as well as overextended in early May 1942, Japan initiated operations to capture Port Moresby by amphibious assault and thus sever communications and supply lines between the United States and Australia. The planned invasion was thwarted when an Allied task force centered on two American fleet carriers fought Japanese naval forces to a draw in the Battle of the Coral Sea. Japan's next plan, motivated by the earlier Doolittle raid, was to seize Midway Atoll and lure American carriers into battle to be eliminated. As a diversion, Japan would also send forces to occupy the Aleutian Islands in Alaska in early June. Japan put its operations into action, but the